Hello and welcome to Melbourne and welcome to my first ever ferry review. Behind me is the Spirit of Tasmania. This ferry company has been transporting passengers between Melbourne and Tasmania since 1985. However, that's about to change. From the 23rd of October, instead of docking in Melbourne, the Spirit of Tasmania will be using its new port in Geelong. I'm going to fly to Devonport tomorrow, and in this video, I will cover the ferry's inaugural sailing from Devonport to Geelong. Let's go! The Spirit of Tasmania is a trading name of the ferry operator TT Line Company, which currently operates two monohull vessels between mainland Australia and Tasmania. The vessels are named Spirit of Tasmania I and Spirit of Tasmania II. They were both built in Finland in 1998 and have the same layout. Each ship has 11 decks. Decks 1 to 6 have the capacity to hold 500 vehicles, while the upper decks can accommodate up to 1400 passengers. Until the 23rd of October, the Spirit of Tasmania uses Station Pier as its terminus in Victoria. Opened in 1854, this historic pier is Melbourne's primary passenger terminal. In terms of the pier's location, it is almost within walking distance from Melbourne CBD. Once you get off the vessel, Melbourne Town Hall is only a 3km drive away, and for passengers who wish to use public transport, Tram Route 109 connects Station Pier directly with Crown Casino, Southern Cross Station, the city, and Melbourne's eastern suburbs. So, why does the Spirit of Tasmania have to move to Geelong? I guess most passengers who chose to catch the ferry instead of flying would be those with a car. The new state-of-the-art terminal in Geelong would provide a smoother passenger vehicle checking and disembarking experience and also improve freight handling. It only takes an hour to drive to Melbourne, and those going to the Great Ocean Road can bypass Melbourne's traffic completely. Welcome to Devonport. It took me just over an hour to fly here from Melbourne. The city is settled on the mouth of the Mersey River. It's the third largest city in Tassie and is home to one of the four major seaports in the state. The Spirit of Tasmania's Devonport terminal is situated on the east side of the river. The Spirit of Tasmania 1 just arrived from an overnight sailing from Melbourne, and it will be operating the inaugural sailing to Geelong tonight. Devonport is located in the centre of Tasmania's north coast. It's just over an hour's drive from Launceston, 3.5 hours from Hobart, and 35 minutes from Burnie. The inaugural sailing from Devonport to Geelong departs at 7:30 tonight. Check-in opens at 5 p.m. and closes strictly 45 minutes prior to scheduled departure. Those planning to take their vehicles on the ship must proceed to the vehicle check-in booth and drive their own cars onto the ship. As I don't have a car, I headed to the terminal building for check-in. The terminal is quite small, with just a few rows of seats. After checking in, I received my boarding pass and a gift bag to commemorate this inaugural sailing. In the bag, there's a certificate of travel, a complimentary drink voucher that can be used on the ship, a small flag, and a pen. Outside the terminal building, you can find a staircase leading to the observation deck. It provides a really close-up view of the vessel. Boarding commenced at 5:15. Passengers without a car are asked to board the ship through a dedicated walkway. Welcome aboard! Same as the airline tickets, the ticket price for the Spirit of Tasmania fluctuates. Things that affect the price include the time of the year, the time of booking, and the number of passengers. Therefore, the best way to check the price is to go to their official website. The ship has 11 decks. 1 to 6 are for cars and trucks. Decks 7 to 10 include public areas, crew and passenger cabins, and deck 11 is just a helicopter landing pad. We are currently on deck 7. On top of the standard ticket, you can purchase a private cabin for extra comfort. The Spirit of Tasmania I has 222 cabins, ranging from bunk beds to luxury queen rooms. They are at either the front section of Deck 7 or on Deck 8. The decks are connected by 4 sets of stairs. There are lifts available for those with limited mobility. I purchased a twin bed private porthole cabin for myself. Online cabin selection is not available on the Spirit of Tasmania. My boarding pass is also the key to unlock the door. The size of the cabin is adequate for 2 people. It has a window, 2 single beds, wall-mounted reading lights, a small table, a desk with 2 power points, a chair, 2 coat hangers, and a private ensuite bathroom. The price of these cabins fluctuates as well. I paid $209 for mine. $209 is for the whole cabin, not per person, which means if you are traveling with someone, you only have to pay $104.50 each. The second cabin type is 4-bed porthole private cabin. It has the exact same facilities as my cabin, except instead of having 2 single beds, there are 2 bunk beds. Interestingly, the price is $209 per cabin as well, or $52.25 per person if divided by 4. The next level down is 4-bed inside private cabin. They are the same as 4-bed porthole cabin, except the room doesn't have a window. There are 2 accessible cabins available on this ship, but you will have to contact the ferry company to ask for the price. Now, the most expensive accommodation on board is a deluxe cabin. There are only 8 of these on each ship, and the room is twice the size of the other cabins. They all are located at the front of the ship, each with 2 large windows, a window side table with 2 chairs, a TV, a fridge, PowerPoint, and a queen bed. The ensuite bathroom is also more spacious. The whole cabin looks more like a 3 to 4 star hotel room. The price tag is a whopping $499, over twice the price of my cabin. If you decide not to purchase any cabins on a night sale, you'll be allocated a recliner free of charge. The recliners are situated in a private lounge surrounded by floor-to-ceiling windows. The seats look comparable to the premium economy seats on an aeroplane, each with an individual reading light, footrest, USB charging port, blanket, and pillow. If you are on a day sailing, these seats cost $39 per person. There are outside decks on decks 7 to 9, allowing passengers to get some fresh air whenever they want to. The decks are divided into smoking and non-smoking areas. Finally, we can now talk about the ship's dining and entertainment facilities. Deck 7 is the home of the TMK restaurant, which stands for Tasmanian Market Kitchen. It features Tasmania's best food produce. The restaurant has hot and continental breakfast options in the morning and a buffet for lunch and dinner. I am starving right now, so I decided to spend $35 to have the buffet, and I'm glad that I made this decision. To celebrate this new era of sailing, the buffet menu was completely redesigned. All the food and drinks are included in the $35, with the exception of alcoholic beverages. And please be aware that all purchases on this ship are card only. All the ingredients look amazingly fresh and appetizing. The entree is a seafood tasting plate. The oysters are big, they come in 3 flavors: soy, ginger, chili, and lime. In terms of the meat, oh, the pork belly skin is so crispy. I also enjoyed the gravy on my roasted beef. Overall, I absolutely loved this buffet. What's more, $35 isn't just for a single entry. After finishing the meal, if you hold on to the receipt, you can leave the restaurant and come back whenever you want until 9 p.m. If you don't wish to dine at the TMK, there's a pantry, which offers pies, sausage rolls, and freshly prepared grab-and-go sandwiches, snacks, and drinks. Alcohols usually generate great revenue for restaurants. On this ship, there are three bars offering a wide range of beer, spirits, and wines. Bar 7 is a sleek modern bar with plenty of cozy chairs for you to relax and socialize. Also situated on deck 7 is a reading room, a tourism hub, and two cinemas with multiple screens of the latest movie releases. The tickets are $10 per adult, $7.50 for pensioners, and $5 for children between the age of 3 and 15. Deck 9 is where the terrace lounge bar is situated. It offers a range of bar snacks such as pizzas for $12 and ham, cheese, and tomato toasties for $7. The seating area features comfortable lounges and flat-screen TVs. There's a game zone located within this precinct. Deck 10 is the highest deck passengers can access on this ship. The top deck lounge has an array of deck chairs and large surrounding glass windows, offering amazing sea views during the day. The bar is near the kids' play area, so parents can enjoy a drink while the little ones are kept busy. It's been over 2 hours since I boarded the ferry. At 7:30, the inaugural sailing to Geelong left Devonport on time.
Tonight's sailing will be the inaugural voyage to our brand new Victorian terminal in Geelong. After sailing between Devonport and Melbourne for 37 years, tonight's sailing certainly masks the beginning of an exciting era for our company. In the gift bags you received at check-in this evening, you'll find a voucher for a complimentary drink that can be used at any of our bars this evening or for a hot beverage tomorrow morning. Once again, we welcome you aboard and we thank you for joining us on this special occasion this evening. Thank you.
After leaving Devonport, the ferry will cross the Bass Strait and Port Phillip Bay, with a total route measuring approximately 420 kilometers. When I went back to the TMK buffet at 8 p.m, the queue had become much longer, but it wasn't hard to find an empty table. My phone's service provider is Telstra. I lost mobile signal 2.5 hours after we left Devonport. There's Wi-Fi coverage in all public areas, including the recliner lounge, but not in the private cabins. The Wi-Fi is not free, but the price is reasonable. If you don't like to pay for the internet, you can stream the free-to-air channel or Tassie road trip videos on your own device free of charge. The ship is scheduled to arrive at 8 o'clock tomorrow morning, with disembarkation commencing at 8:30. There's nothing to see outside the window. I'm going to head to bed. Good night. Good morning. I haven't been on an overnight ferry for over 10 years. I found the sailing to be very smooth. I slept well. The bed is long, the quilt is warm, and the mattress is firm. The air conditioning in each cabin is individually controlled. I can adjust the temperature to my liking. It's time for a shower. A towel is provided for each bed. The bathroom isn't as spacious as the one in the deluxe cabin, but it's functional. A hand, hair, and body, 3-in-1 total body cleaner is provided in the shower. The water pressure is good, but I think the temperature could be hotter. Still, I'm quite happy with it. For breakfast, I decided to head to the TMK again. For continental options, each item is priced individually, and for the hot breakfast, you can put as much food as you like on a plate for $12. Again, I think it is of great value. We are almost in Geelong. Victoria's coastline can be seen in the distance. Shifting the port from Melbourne to Geelong is definitely welcoming news for Geelong and West Melbourne locals. This inaugural sailing has attracted lots of media attention. Welcome to Geelong. This is the end of the inaugural sailing, however, the celebration only just started. An official opening ceremony of the new passenger terminal was held not long after the ship's arrival.
This represents once in a generation move for Spirit of Tasmania, but this is just the first box that we are ticking today. We have two new ships arriving in 2024, and we have a port relocation also in Devonport, our existing port in Tasmania, so that will be upgraded. So there are a lot of very, very positive things going on with Spirit of Tasmania.
Our freight community and the Tasmanian community and tourists right around Australia have responded and said, thank goodness, far better. We won't have to navigate those busy metropolitan streets with our motorhomes, caravans and cars.
But the big winners here today are Tasmania. Because for the first time, Tasmanians coming aboard the Spirit of Tasmania will be arriving at the cultural centre point, the true heart of the state of Victoria.
Geelong's new state-of-the-art terminal building is 2,131 square meters in size. It features check-in desks, a cafe, plenty of seats, charging stations, and a kids' playing area. There are also models of the current and past Spirit of Tasmania vessels on display. Outside the building, there's even a pet zone, as well as free parking for vehicles, a dedicated undercover drop-off and pickup zone, and a marshalling area for 600 cars. The only downside of this new facility is that there's currently no public transport connecting the terminal with Geelong CBD. The closest train station to Melbourne and Geelong is North Shore. It is a 20-minute walk away, and the trip to Melbourne will now take over an hour by train. Thank you so much for watching. If you have enjoyed this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more train, flight and ferry reviews. See you all in my next video. It will be filmed in Turkey.